to be you. I wanted a
kindergarten Sunday school class.
What attracted you to her?
Her big dimples.
Okay. And Edna, what attracted you to Ken?
He looked like a little innocent country boy.
When did you know he was the one?
Oh, I didn't know for quite a while, but my mom thought he was tall. She always said, look for somebody tall. He was 5'11" and a half, and young, I thought he might grow a little bit even.
It had to be you.
I wanted to about a week after I met her. I was 5 years old, but that was all right.
What was her response?
Oh, yes, yes, yes. And her mother was yes, 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 too.
It had to be you. It had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who could make me be true. Could make me be blue, or even be glad, just to be sad, thinking of you. Some others I've seen might never be mean, might never be cross, or try to be boss, but they wouldn't do for nobody else. Gave me a thrill with all your faults.
Well, more romantic then than now. I've got the diamonds to prove it.
In the paper that
we went north, and we did. We went as far north as Wisconsin Dells. That's about how much money we had for gas. And Wisconsin Dells at that time was just a booth with two rides. Just one little building, a ticket booth, and one ride went up and one went down. And do you remember which one we done?
The upper one?
Yeah, we couldn't afford them both, so we done one of them.
Yeah.
What's wrong with these kids today?
Well, it's the funniest thing. I think most parents think what the kids will be and what they'll turn out to be. And I have to say, there isn't one of them done what I thought they should do. It's true.
Were any of the children good at farming? Milking cows?
None of them wanted to work.
Kids, who who can understand anything they say?
Kid. By the time he rang up, I had to go get him. He was down in the timber off of Grand View down by the river. And he actually said, run out of gas. He said, run out of gas down here. Well, he said, I'm looking for a gas station. Yeah, he's the only guy and a couple that I know would go to a timber down by the river in a mosquito hole looking for a gas station.
Kids, they are disobedient, disrespectful oafs. Noisy, crazy, sloppy, lazy loafers.
Well, Dan was a klutz, you know. He was, if there was a stick anything bigger than a toothpick, Danny would trip over, you know.
You can talk till your face is blue.
Were you ever able to get a hard day's work out of Jeff?
Not too many. He's pretty foxy, Jeff is.
I didn't know what puberty was until I was almost past it. Laughing, singing, dancing, grabbing morons.
We got a letter from the college not to send him back. We needed serious students.
Don't look at me.
Yeah, well, I said they take after your side. They have.
Yeah. Why can't they be like we were, perfect in every way? What's the matter with kids today?
Well, I usually went along with Ken, but over my dead body is my kid sitting in jail.
Skies are gonna clear up, put on a happy face. Brush off the clouds and cheer up, put on a happy face. Take off the gloomy mask of tragedy, it's not your style. You look so good that you'll be glad you decided to smile. Pick out a pleasant outlook, stick out that noble chin. Wipe off that full of doubt look, slap on a happy grin, and spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. Put on a happy face. And if you're feeling cross and bickerish, don't sit and whine. Think of banana splits and licorice, and you feel fine. I knew a girl so gloomy, she'd never laugh or sing. She wouldn't listen to me, now she's a mean old thing. So spread sunshine all over the place. Just put on a happy face. Thank you. it had to be you. I wandered around and finally found the somebody who could make me be true.
Ken and I are really rich, and our riches are in the family. And this is the interest that we got this year. She's 2 months old. Her name is Sophia Elizabeth, and she belongs to Andy and Amy Mozina. And Daryl and Terry are the grandparents. And she's really loved, and she's gorgeous.
With all your faults, I love you still.
Ken and I really do want to thank everyone for coming and sharing with us. We haven't had 60 years of wedded bliss because we had some sad years. But I would do it again, and it's been fun. Mm-hmm. It's your turn, Dad.
Well, I'd have to think about that a little bit, but I suppose that's it. We've had to... I've enjoyed my life. It was hard work in the business we was in, but I've sure met thousands and thousands of people and did business for thousands of people, and really enjoyed it. Raised a good family, had some tough luck, but we're real blessed with the family we have, the way they're doing and the way the grandkids are doing. The great granddaughter, don't forget her. She's our pride and joy.